effusive, and I mean effusive, praise for the tax bill and the president from the chairman of the Senate Finance Committee, Orrin Hatch. Watch this.
Mr. President, I have to say that you're living up to everything I thought you would. You're one heck of a leader, and we're all benefiting from it. This is just the beginning. You stop and think about it. This president hasn't even been in office for a year. And look at all the things that he's been able to get done by sheer will in many ways.
He actually went on to say he could be the greatest president ever. That gentleman right there, rubbing his eyes, maybe in disbelief, I don't know, but he is the senator, the great senator from Louisiana. His name is John Kennedy. Sir, would you second that effusive praise, over the top in some respects, for our president?
Yes, I would. And Stuart, let me just say this. I told you we were going to cut your taxes, and by God, we did it. And to all of our Democratic friends who don't want their tax cuts, I say to them, look, send them to me, room 383, Russell Senate Office Building, and I will distribute them to the people of Louisiana because we will take them.
Did you practice that? You did, sir, didn't you? You practiced.
No.
You put out the name of your room.
And I know what Speaker Pelosi is, our former Speaker Pelosi is saying. And to her, I would say, look, you shouldn't be fibbing at Christmas, all right? It's Christmas. This bill is going to cut taxes for just about every American. When you double the standard deduction, when you double the child tax credit, when you lower the marginal rates, people are going to have more take-home pay, and they deserve it because they can spend the money they earn better than government can. And businesses are going to see tax cuts, and their employees are going to notice it right away because they're going to have more co-employees as new people are hired and as new things like software are purchased and new plants and machinery and equipment. Those employees, new and old, will be made more productive and their wages will go up. The wages are going to go up if for no other reason but wage pressure. I think this is a great bill.
Okay, I've got to ask you about the grilling that you gave to one of President Trump's judicial nominees earlier this week. I know you were there. For the benefit of our viewers, roll tape, please.
Tried a jury trial?
I have not.
Civil?
No.
Criminal?
No.
Bench?
No.
State or federal court?
I have not.
As a trial judge, you're obviously going to have witnesses.
Yes.
Can you tell me what the Daubert standard is?
Senator Kennedy, I don't have that readily at my disposal.
Senator, you destroyed him, and his nomination was withdrawn. The media seized on this and said it's typical of President Trump's nominees. What's your response to that?
It's not typical. The president has sent to us in the Senate, and we have confirmed some extraordinarily able lawyers who will be great federal judges. Mr. Peterson, who did withdraw his nomination, is a smart man. I read his FBI background report. He's honest. He's capable. But he's not ready to be a trial judge. President Trump called me the day after the hearing, and he said, Kennedy, I'm not upset. I'm not mad. Do your job. I appreciate you doing your job. He said, what do you think we ought to do? I said, Mr. President, I think you ought to withdraw Mr. Peterson's nomination. I don't want to seem embarrassed anymore. The president said, I think that's what we ought to do. And that's really what happened. My job on judiciary is to catch any mistakes that might have been made in the vetting process. And that's what I did. And the president said, just keep doing your job, Kennedy. So I am.
Okay, Mr. Senator. Great pleasure having you on the show. I'm sure we'll see you again real soon. Thank you, sir.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, sir, indeed. Thank you.